back to the Metal Hunter. My name is Luke. I'm back with another reaction. I'm a bit nervous about this one. It's something very, very different to what I usually react to. You know, I started this channel back in 2018 with the intention of just kind of reacting and talking about and staying within the confines of heavy metal, whether it be thrash, black, death, fucking grindcore, metalcore, deathcore, all that kind of shit. But as I've said previously, you know, I'm a fan of music first and foremost. That's what I love. You know, I like to be challenged. I like to dance. I like to sing along. I like to bob my head. Sometimes I just want to switch my brain off. So I do listen to a lot of music outside of the metal genre. You know, I enjoy pop and hip hop, and I enjoy folk music. Sometimes I enjoy country music. I mean, I do live in the sticks and I do wear a flannel a lot, so I probably should listen to that kind of music. So it's not outside of the realm for me to listen to a band like Chvrches. I have been recommended these guys. Forgive me, I can't remember who recommended it to me. I did have it written down somewhere to have a look. I can't find it. But to whoever recommended it to me, thank you so much. I do enjoy this band. I actually really like their cover of the Arctic Monkeys song that they do on the Triple J YouTube channel, where they did like a version. I think that they have an incredible sense of melody and an incredible sense of, you know, writing really good hooks. So for those of you who are coming in as a metalhead, if you're not into this music, just move on to the next one. We'll catch you on the next episode, whatever. I'm just trying out something new. If you're a pop fan, hopefully I give you a bit of insight from an outsider, you know, someone who's a metalhead and listens to a lot of extreme music. For those of you who are just music fans and you're just interested to see what this bearded fuckwit is talking about, this one's for you. Now, Chvrches is a band from Glasgow, Scotland, formed in September 2011. The band consists of Lauren Mabry, Ian Cook, Martin Doherty, and unofficially since 2018, Johnny Scott. Now, these guys release fairly sugary pop music, but they have I think that they have a bit of a new wave vibe about them, and I think that's what really attracts me to some of their music. My wife absolutely loves these guys, so when they're on, I'm not offended. I'm not like, fuck, turn this off. This is disgusting. This is just like sugary pop or whatever. So they're kind of like they're a group that I think that they write some really, really good songs. The song that I'm going to be reacting to is called Leave a Trace. Now, I'm like 99% sure that I haven't heard this song before. The track name I don't recognize it. It's not from an album that I've intentionally listened to. So from what I can tell, this will be my first reaction to this song. All right, before I do get into this, I know it's a bit of a weird one, but hey, I've got to do my housekeeping. Make sure that you like the video. Make sure that you subscribe. If you don't like the video, just fuck off. Don't give me a thumbs down or anything like that. There's no fucking point. Or just tell me in the comments why you don't like it. I don't care about the thumbs down. Like, it doesn't do anything to me, and it also doesn't explain to me why you don't like it. I'd love to hear from you guys. I want to start a conversation. All right. Like, subscribe, follow me on Facebook, follow me on Instagram. Apparently, I've got a Twitter. I didn't even know about that, so I've got one of those. Go and check that out. Okay, so this is taken from the album Every Open Eye, which was released on the 25th of September 2015, so it's 6 years old. Let's get my headphones on the right way. And let's fucking get poppy. Man, this is gonna piss off the metalheads. I gave up on time, just like you said you would. There are tiny cracks of light underneath me, and you say I got it wrong. But I try hard to uncover them.
I'm
imagine being at a music festival. 15 to 16 drinks in. Please come across. Give me shivers. I know I need to feel release. Take care to tell it just as it was. Take care to tell me for the cause. I know I need to feel release. Take care to bury all that you can. Take care to leave a trace of a man. Such a good song. I definitely hadn't heard it before today. Okay, so this is going to be a little bit different. If you're new to the channel, you probably notice that I don't pause the song. The reason that I don't do that is because I don't feel like that is actually reacting to the song. The artist writes the song from start to finish with everything put into it so you can listen to it and we can listen to it in a full go. And that's why I react the way that I react. So I listen to the whole song. I get hit with copyright claims all the fucking time. I don't care about that. I could get my channel blocked tomorrow. It doesn't fucking matter to me. What matters to me is enjoying the music for what it is. You could probably even just tell by watching me watch that song or listen to that song that I fucking really enjoyed that. Vocally, wow. Like, I mean, I'm obviously not surprised because I'm familiar with Lauren's voice. But the way that they basically, it was clipped into like three parts of the song. So there was like that intro, build into that big chorus, that low kind of bass rumbling at the bottom, and then Lauren's voice just kind of floating above. That to me is perfect pop music. There's something kind of dark and almost aggressive about this. Not aggressive in the terms of metal, but aggressive in the terms of she seemed like she was really standing up for herself in this situation. I don't know what the lyrics are about. Like, I don't know what the song itself is about. If you know about that, let me know down below. I'd love to hear from you guys. But it definitely sounded like she'd been pushed into a corner, pushed into a situation that she didn't want to be involved with, or pushed by someone that she knows that is a fucking piece of shit, you know? And I think, you know, you can hear that in pop music sometimes, like, you know, at least on the outskirts of pop. You know, you go to the top 40 and whatever, they're going to be singing about some sugary bullshit that, you know, sometimes you're not going to want to hear. But if you look for pop music, if you look for some pop music, you're going to find some stuff out there that's really, really incredible. I really love the way that this song was orchestrated. I like the way that it was put together. It had my attention the entire time. Obviously, the production was incredible. The music video itself was beautiful to look at. Lauren is beautiful herself, if I'm, you know, so bold to say so. The song itself was enchanting, really. Here's where I'm, like, really nervous. I want to hear from you guys. I want to hear what you guys think of this song. I want to know what, you know, even if you're a metalhead, if you think it sucks, I don't know. Just whatever. Watch the next video. I'm going to try and do these more often. Maybe once a week I might do a pop song. If you've got a pop track or, like, you know, something a little bit different, let me know down below. I'd really love to hear from you. One more thing before I do go. If you like this band Chvrches, I definitely recommend checking out a band called The 1975. I feel like they'd have a lot of crossover fans. It's a very similar kind of, like, low drone-y bass with, like, high vocals over the top. Yeah, just kind of, you know, a little bit of extra advice for you guys. Like, subscribe, follow me on all of the social medias, all that good shit. I've been Luke, the Metal Hunter. Well, not so much Metal Hunter. We'll catch you later. Bye.